All right, welcome. Hi, I'm Tianna, and I am teaching for the Veterans Yoga Project, live streaming classes. And in this practice, we'll be using a chair as our prop, so could be appropriate for those that are unable to get to the floor and then back up again easily. I will be doing some standing poses, though, using the chair as a prop, so we'll go through a little bit of flow. And then you might want a strap or a belt works really well, or long stretchy pants. I mean, it doesn't have to be anything special, even a long towel would work. So I've got that ready for practice. All right, well, let's begin. So settling comfortably in your seat. We'll start with a little bit of mindful movement. So as you inhale, we'll start to drift the shoulders up towards your ears. Active doing, and then when you're ready, exhale, let the shoulders roll back and down. This active not doing. Continuing on your own breath rhythm, that full length of your inhale gets the shoulders up, and the full length of your exhale draws the shoulders back down. Maybe one or two more rounds, your choice. All right, if you're ready to settle in, just letting the shoulders drop away from the ears to rise from the shoulders, allowing the eyes to close or be open in a steady gaze, whatever helps you to tune into your body and tune out to the distractions. Start to notice the ground supporting you. Can you feel the sensation of your big toes, your little toes, your heels? The sensation of the surface on the backs of your thighs to your sit bones. And just feeling that centeredness right between the sit bones and not like you're heavily weighted on one side versus the other. So bringing yourself back to center. Lengthening the spine from the base all the way to the top of the head, and then the chin just resting in ever so slightly. Begin to tune into your other senses, beginning to notice the sounds of the room. Sound of your breath or the absence of the sound of your breath. Sensation of the air flowing in and out the tips of the nostrils. You may notice the temperature on the way in is a little different than the temperature on the way out. Beginning to notice as you breathe in that the belly gently rises or expands away from your spine. And as you breathe out, it floats back towards center. And if it helps you, you can place maybe right hand over belly, left hand over heart space. So as you breathe in, the belly gently expands into that lower hand. Maybe the chest rises ever so slightly, nothing extravagant. And as you exhale, let everything float back towards center. Maybe two or three more breaths, just like this. Letting that need to go to effort too much here. So just breathing in naturally and smoothly and not trying too hard. Your next exhale, just letting the hands rest down and gently beginning to let the eyes open whenever you're ready. All right, start with a little bit of movement here with starting with your right hand over your heart space or your chest, and you're going to start to sweep that hand across your chest as you open it out to the right, gazing out to the right, and then slide that hand back across the chest, landing over your heart space. This might be your inhale. And on your exhale, you're going to sweep that hand out again, extending, reaching out over to the right. And this time, let's look over towards the left as we come back to the left. Good. Last time, exhaling out to the right. Inhaling as we come back to the left. Good. Come back to center and release your right hand down and take your left hand over your heart space or your chest space. Good. So we'll take an inhale here and exhale as you turn that head out to the left. And come back to center on your in-breath, gazing out to the right. Two more times. Exhale, reach out to the left, look to the left. Inhale, come back to center and look to the right. Last one. All right, we'll be back in the center. Relax that hand down. Great. Let's head through a seated cat and cow. So as you we're gonna start with a tailbone tuck. So you're gonna tip your tailbone, start to round the back to as much as it feels comfortable today. Maybe drop the shoulders and the head. When you're ready to inhale, turn the palms up, untuck the tailbone and start to slide back up. Arching the back slightly, just enough effort. Inhale, maybe chin lifts. Good. Exhale, rounding down. It's gonna turn to the side, you can see that. Continue on your own breath rhythm. Maybe one more time on your own rhythm. Good. And we'll meet back in the center. Great. Let's take one hand, your right hand over to the side of the chair or the side of your thigh, and the left arm is going to reach up and over. I'm going to send my left sit bone down to the chair. And you could decide if looking down feels best, looking forward, or maybe looking up feels best today. Find some ease in your effort. One more breath. We'll press left sit bone down, reach the left arm up, and then exhale. We'll be back in the center. Take your left hand down to the side of the chair. Bring your right arm up. And same thing. Find some ease in your efforts. This does not have to be shoulders to ears. Send your right sit bone down. And decide where you're going to gaze, down, up, or forward. Great, one more breath. Press your right sit bone down, reach your right arm up, and then exhale, we'll be back up in the center. Check those shoulders out. All right, let's take your strap, if you got it, or a belt, or whatever device you are using. And I'm going to start taking this out wide. We're going to take a rise up in breath. Out breath, coming back to center. In breath. Again, push to the side. You can see what that looks like. If you felt like you have enough room to go back behind you, you're welcome to. You don't have to though, nor should you be contorting the body to get there. You kind of lose the purpose if you do, you know, try to shimmy, shimmy, shake back there. Always stopping wherever it feels comfortable and the most nourishing. Let me do one more here. When you're ready, we'll be back in the center. All right, I'm gonna start here at the very top. Like you're holding onto a stick, inhale up and exhale over. Gaze down to the right as I head to the right. Inhale back up and exhale over to the left. And then we'll meet back up in the center, release, and you can set your strap down for the moment. All right. Let's take the, if you've got a block, you can use it. If you don't worry about it. You can always use a block or a step stool, or just use the floor or your legs. So we're going to go on down into wisdom pose or child's pose, seated version. So your wisdom pose or your child's might look like this. You can stop there. You could come down to a block or a step stool. You could come down to your feet or the floor. I'm just going to rest down to the floor since I can reach it. Take a full breath in. Let your belly expand towards your thighs. Exhale, maybe mouth open. Relax your jaw. Maybe one or two more breaths. Relax the back of your neck if that feels safe. When you're ready, slowly start to walk back up your legs. Your head's the last thing to join you at the top. And just don't stay there too long if you've got glaucoma or you have really fluctuating blood pressure. All right, set the block to the side. We're gonna take the right leg out and the left leg is also out, it's just bent. So coming into warrior two. It does help to be a little bit scooched forward to the front of the seat. Good, and I'm gonna start here in the center, elbows out, spreading those fingers as wide as they feel comfortable. A little bit of pressure here as you push the palms together and lift the spine. One full breath. Okay, we're gonna keep a little bit of pressure as we reach to the sky and then span out cactus arms, warrior two. So used to doing cactus arms there. We're gonna soften the shoulders here. Good. I'm gonna invite you to inhale, turn the palms up. And exhale, turn the palms down. So arms are rotating all the way from the shoulders and the collarbones out to the fingertips. Next time the palms go up, let's pause there, gazing out towards the left. Invite the back hand, turn it down. Take it down the back of your back leg and reach that left arm to the sky. You could just relax the neck and gaze forward. You could look up. You can also bend your elbow or keep it right on your front thigh. In breath, reaching. Exhale, come back to warrior two, palms down, peaceful pose two. We'll inhale, reach to the sky. Meet the palms together, see if you can do it without looking at them. And then a little bit of pressure as we come back down towards center. Great. And then we'll help that leg back in. You can do a little shake off of the shoulders or the hips before we meet back in warrior two or peaceful pose two to the other side. So right leg is your bent leg now, left leg is your straight. We're sitting up tallish, try to get tall. Bring the palms together, a little bit of pressure there and spread those fingers out to the best of your ability. Elbows out, full breath in and out here. If you're ready, we'll start to rise up. A little bit of pressure, just enough. And when you're ready to let the arms release, coming out to warrior two or peaceful pose two. Soften the shoulders a bit. So pressing through the feet. We'll take an inhale, turn the palms up, rotating from the entire shoulder outward, and then exhale down. Two more. Extend the palms, turn up, we'll pause there. And soften the shoulders a bit. We'll take the back palm, face it down, and slide it down the back leg and reach the front arm to the sky. Only look up if it feels okay. You can also look forward. And again, you could bend the elbow and reach from there or have your hand on the front thigh. So make it feel nourishing wherever you've chosen. One more breath. Good, reaching, then we're back, meeting in warrior two. Soften the arms. Gazing out to the right, one more breath. Good, we'll start to bring the arms back up to center, gazing to the center. Meet the palms in the center, in the middle, without looking at them if you can. And then slide them back to center. One full breath here. All right. We'll help that leg back in. Good, and you can shake off the shoulders if you'd like, or the hips. All right, and then we'll start to take our way into standing. So I'll use a bit of conscious effort here, if you're able to. Bring your feet about hip width apart, and then we'll start to hinge forward. Hands can be on the thighs or your seat. We're gonna exhale and slowly rise up. You could free the arms up if that's available to you. All right, if your equilibrium is with you and you're ready to shift, let's start to take the chair over to one side. It doesn't matter which side. Okay, so So I'm going to go through, we're going to do a bit of a salutation here, Zen salutation using the chair. So facing your surface, feet about hip width apart. I'll ask you to pick your toes up if that's available to you. Spread them wide, send your pinky down, and then drive the other toes towards center. And then just take a moment to notice, are you putting equal weight through both feet, front to back? And how do you find your center? Right in the middle. From this strong mountain pose, we'll rise up, in breath, greet the sky. Out breath, we're going to bend the knees and send the hands to the chair. Good. Halfway up, inhale, so I can come up onto my fingertips. Good. And exhale, I start to come forward. So I could stop there. If you have the availability to come down forward on the chair, you're welcome to. And some of you might even be able to go down where your hands are on the bottom of the chair. So I'll do an in-between version and you decide which is best for you. You can rock the hips a bit side to side. If this does not feel great on your back today, please don't stay here. I know you'll use your best intuition, hopefully, to keep your body safe at home. One more breath. If you're ready, start to walk your hands back up underneath you, bending the knees a bit more, and we're going to exhale, slowly rise up. When you're ready, inhale to reach to the sky, extended mountain, and exhale, come back down. Okay. We're going to do that once more, and then we'll start to add a few things in. So inhale, rising, exhale, bend the knees, extending forward. Halfway up, inhale, lengthening, and exhale, start to make your way down. Again, you can stop at your hands, your forearms, or you could go to the lower rungs of the chair, or some of you might be able to reach the floor. Relax the back of the neck. Keep the knees a little bit bent if that would help with your low back and your hamstrings. One more breath. We'll start to bend the knees a bit more. Walk the hands back up onto the chair. They're not already. And then exhale to rise up slowly. When you're ready, inhale, greet the sky. Extended mountain. And find yourself back. Mountain pose. This time we're going to add in a downward facing dog. Actually, we'll go from chair pose to downward dog. So let's rise up. In breath, follow along. Sitting your tush back to as best as you can here. Always feel nourishing. Inhale, exhale, folding forward. Halfway up, in breath. And plant the hands. Whole parts of the hand is on the chair, and then you're going to walk back. Downward facing dog. Spreading those fingers out wide, just as though you were on the floor. You can rock your hips side to side here if that feels good. If you rock your head side to side, your ears would be roughly in line with your upper arms. One more breath. We'll bend the knees. We'll start to walk forward. Inhale. Lengthen the spine. Exhale, bend the knees a bit to rise up slowly. When you're ready, inhale, meet at the top. Extended mountain. Exhale, mountain pose. We'll go one more time with that. In breath, rising up. Exhale, sitting back, chair pose, Utkatasana. In breath, out breath, hands to the chair. Halfway up, inhale, lengthen. Plant the hands down, step back, downward facing dog. Keeping the knees bent if that feels best. Draw the shoulder blades out of the ears and all parts of the hand on the chair, the surface that you're using. One more breath. We'll bend the knees, walking slowly forward. Inhale to lengthen. Bend the knees a bit and exhale to rise up. Extended mountain, in breath. Back to mountain, out breath. Now we'll do the same thing, but we're going to add in a warrior one here. So, rising up, in breath. Coming back to chair pose. Folding forward. Inhale halfway up. Bend the knees. Step back. Downward facing dog. You're going to turn your left foot. So pivoting on your heel just a bit to the outward towards the left. And then take your right foot forward. Bend into that front knee, which could buttress up against this chair for a little more stability. And then we're going to rise up in breath. Pause in here. Warrior one. Find some ease in your effort. In breath. Reach a little to the sky. Exhale. Offer forward. Extending. Hands to chair. Step back. Downward facing dog. We'll turn the right foot slightly out. This time, take the left foot forward. Bend into the front knee again. It could be buttressed up against that chair. Rise up in breath. Settle the shoulders out of the ears, out breath. One more breath, rising up. Hands back to the chair, step back, downward facing dog. Find some ease in your effort. Keep the knees bent if that feels good, or try to straighten them if that feels better. And bend the knees when you're ready. Walking it forward. Inhale, lengthen. Bend the knees, exhale, rising up, meet the top, in breath, extended mountain, back to mountain, full breath. Realign your feet if they got out of line. Okay, here we go. Doing that whole series one more time, in breath, out breath, chair pose. Find the chair, exhale, inhale, halfway up. Plant the hands, step back, downward dog. And we're going to turn the right foot slightly out. This time, take your left foot forward. Rising up, warrior one, peaceful pose one. Reach the sky, in breath. Offer forward, out breath, until your hands meet the chair. Step back, downward facing dog. Turn the left foot slightly out, bring the right foot forward. Rising up, warrior one, peaceful pose one. In breath, reach the sky, press through the back heel, offer forward, hands planted, step back, downward dog. We're there for two or three breaths. Find some ease in your effort. Bend the knees if you're ready to come up. Stepping forward. Inhale, lengthen. Bend the knees a bit. Exhale, rise up. Inhale when you reach the top. Exhale, find mountain pose. One full breath. All right. Wonderful. So I'm just going to grab a block here. You may not need it. You can certainly use the chair. It depends on your flexibility. I'm going to bring the right foot forward and the left foot back. So we've got this kind of pyramid pose of the legs. So my front foot is just grazing up underneath the front of the chair. I'll bend into the front knee and rise up in breath. Coming into warrior two. Sorry, warrior one. In breath, reach the sky. Offer forward. We've done this before. This time, you're going to plant the hands, and instead of stepping back, we're going to start to straighten that front leg. Now, this is where, if the chair seems too far away, a block could help get you a little bit higher. And for some of you, you might be able to come down forearms to the block, or forearms to the chair, or some of you might be able to go down towards the lower rungs. I'm going to stay somewhere right in the middle. So my back hip is hugging forward, my front hip is hugging back. Draw the shoulder blades out of the ears and find some ease in your effort. And that might be bending the front knee just a little bit more. One more breath if you're still there. Start to walk back up onto the hands if you're not already bending into that front knee. Rising up through warrior one, in breath. Exhale, soften the shoulders. In breath, reaching, exhale, sweep the arms down. And then we'll step back, find mountain pose, one full breath. All right, when you're ready, we'll take the left foot forward and line up just as we did before. Just honoring that one side might be a little different than the other, so. All right, bending into that left leg, rising up, warrior one, soften the shoulders, pressing through the back heel. One more breath, in breath, out breath, offer forward. Hands to the chair or the block, straighten the front leg. That might be your stop point, or maybe you're up on the block. Or maybe you lower down to your forearms, or maybe down to the lower rungs of the chair. You'll find a comfortable spot for not only those hamstrings, but also your low back. Back hip is hugging forward, front hip is hugging slightly back. Shoulders out of the ears, and find some ease in your effort. Two more breaths if you'd like. Bend the front knee, start to walk back up onto the hands. Keep that front knee bent as we rise through warrior one. In breath, out breath, soften the shoulders. Good inhale, reach to the sky. Exhale, sweep the arms down by the side as you straighten that front leg. And then step back to find mountain pose. One full breath. I'm going to show up. We're going to do a balance pose here using the chair, half moon pose. So the chair is on my left side. If you're using it, you can use any other piece of furniture too. Left foot's facing that chair, almost like you're setting up for warrior two. Maybe we'll head through warrior two to get there. So reaching, warrior two, bend into the front knee. You're going to take that hand, I'm going to actually move the block, but you could use the block, hand to the chair right under your shoulder, and then the opposite leg is going to start to lift up. So you want to make sure that hand, lower hand is right under your shoulder, and maybe reach from your heart space all the way up towards the sky. See if flexing the foot helps the back foot. And you could gaze forward. If you feel comfortable and safe enough to start to take your gaze upward, give it a try, slowly. Steady breath, ease. Okay, one more breath if you're still there. We'll take that hand down, back towards the heart space, pause, bend the standing leg. Reach the back leg down and exhale, rise through warrior two, gazing out to your left. And then we'll straighten the front leg and then heel toe, step it in. And mountain pose, one full breath, reset. All right, I'm gonna switch the chair over, just adjust yourself for reversing sides. We'll take the right foot out, bending into that standing leg. Warrior two, gazing out to the right. Take that front hand down to the chair right under your shoulder. Start to straighten out the front leg and lift the back leg. You're gonna come across the chest, rise up. You could look up again if that feels safe, otherwise look forward, maybe even down. Steady breath, feel your big toes. One more breath if you're still there. We'll sweep that hand down across the chest again. Bend the standing leg, reach the back leg back, rising into warrior two. Good. Come back to center, heel toe, step it in, find mountain pose. Great. Let's take it back to the chair for our final rest and relaxation. So come back to your seated mountain pose in your chair or on the floor if you're able to. And actually, let's rest back, maybe in the chair. Let the feet extend outward and legs extend outward. You can have a block under your feet or pillows. Maybe palms down. Allow the shoulders to settle out of your ears. Eyes to close or keep them open in a steady gaze, your choice. Take you through a brief guided relaxation. We'll rest for a quiet minute or so, and then I'll begin to bring you back out. Allowing the skin of the forehead to smooth out. Face between the eyebrows softens and broadens. Temples release. Eyes are heavy. Joint of the jaw releasing, creating space between the teeth, letting go of the tongue. Shoulder blades out of the ears. Steady flow of the breath. Your mind starts to wander. Stop the thought and bring your awareness back to wherever you feel the breath moving in and moving out. You have nowhere to be and nothing to do. These next few moments are yours. You're welcome to spend more time here. If you're ready to exit out, take a more full, conscious breath, allowing the belly to expand, maybe the heart space to lift. And a slow, steady exhale, maybe mouth open. Full extension stretch, like a dog stretch or a cat stretch. Maybe bringing a knee to the chest. And back out, the other knee to the chest. And back out. Come into a more upright position. We'll inhale, the arms open. Exhale, cross one arm over the other. Give yourself a hug, full breath in and out. Inhale. Switch the arm that was on top. Wrap around, full breath in and out. Inhale, open. Bring the palms together or one hand over the other, over your heart space, whatever feels most authentic. Bowing to a place within you where you recognize gratitude, to silently acknowledge at least one more thing in your life to be grateful for today. Breathing in and breathing out. Namaste. Thank you.